हेलो एवरीवन, आई होप यू गाइस कैन हियर मी ऑल राइट. ओके, सो वेलकम टू दिस सेशन. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर अटेंडिंग एंड आई होप यू गाइस गेट टू फाइंड सम वैल्यू आउट ऑफ इट. या सो माय नेम इज़ आयशा नसीम एंड लेट मी जस्ट शेयर अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट माय सेल्फ. सो इट माइट नॉट लुक लाइक इट बट आई हैव क्वाइट सम एक्सपीरियंस इन द फील्ड ऑफ IT, AI एंड मशीन लर्निंग. आई हैव अ मास्टर्स इन डेटा साइंस एंड हैव बीन एबल टू स्केल अप अ फुल स्टैक starting from idea inception to preparing complex data pipelines, model training, packaging the models, and then going enterprise scale, CI/CD, monitoring and support. So I work at Allegis Group as an MLOps engineer, and Allegis Group is a global leader in HR staffing and services. So the work that I would be presenting here with you today is actually my personal projects. So yeah. Let me now delve into the topics. Yeah. So, as you all know, we have gotten to this age, acquired a lot of data. We know how to process the data because of the enhancement in the computing. And so the decade long machine learning algorithms have actually become a reality. Starting from AI based tutoring, the Khan Amigo of the Khan Academy, to GE's Predix, the industrial internet of things like intelligent power turbines. So the AI has been used anywhere and everywhere throughout the functions. So yes, so similarly in investment decision making in this vertical as well, a lot of efforts have been made to make this AI capable. And because of the market, it's so gruesome, it's so dynamic, a lot of efforts have been made so far. You know, people invest a lot of time to make optimized decision making. So these AI capabilities help provide a lot of support. So I wanted to join the bandwagon, and I have a few projects that I would be showcasing with you today. And just a note, because just to be mindful of the time, I won't be going through any of the machine learning concepts, any of the reinforcement learning concepts, or generative AI concept, just to be mindful of the time. But then I'll be happy to answer any of the questions if you have any. Yes, so the first project that I wanted to show you was the autonomous stock portfolio management system using deep reinforcement learning. And it's an ensemble strategy where there are multiple agents who are actually competing against each other to do the trading. And trading in the form of buying, holding, and selling autonomously. And where they're getting all the fuel from, where they're getting in the runtime all the information from, actually it's the environment that I have prepared. Yeah, so the environment consists of a variety of stocks that I selected, and I will tell you more about that later on. The selection was done more based on the volatility, from the volatility perspective. So yes, that, and then the environment has multiple technical indicators for each of the stock per time period when the trading is going on. And then I also added the sentiment score from the news publications for each of the stock, for the agents to thrive from that data as well. So yes, this is a little bit of a snapshot of how this model actually works, what's the outcome, and a little bit about it. So now let me just give you a walkthrough of the technologies. And what I wanted to share with you here is, of course, the language is Python, but the libraries that I used is this OpenAI GYM library to create the reinforcement learning model and the environment. And then this table baseline 3 that you see, it is to evaluate the reinforcement learning models. And the data sources were Yahoo Finance API to actually get the stock prices, and Fred Data to get the economical data. And then I actually wanted to go with the tweets coming out of X, but I could not get access to the advanced developer account, which is why I had to reside to Kaggle News for now, but there's scope in that as well. So yes, this is my most favorite slide. I love it because it explains pretty much everything. So if you see that blue strip on top, and then you see this current amount is say at time zero, when I start off So say I put $10,000, right? So in the beginning, it would be $10,000. And as the system operates, the balance or the current amount, it keeps on changing, right? And then for each of the stock, there's count of shares for each of the stock, and then the stock price at that time period, and then all the technical indicators, the leading, lagging, and the coincident technical indicators for each of the stock. And then there's sentiment score that you see over there. Yeah. So this is the environment. And the agents that you see, the three agents that you see, they are actually the neural networks, the models, deep learning models. They are actor-critique, based on actor-critique algorithms. And these three are competing each other to participate in the trading. So the box that you see is the ensemble strategy. And let me just give you a little bit of a walkthrough of what I did here. So the first period that you see is the training period. And all three agents are trained simultaneously. And then once the training is done of all the three agents, then the actual trading starts. So the trading period is divided into per 3 months. So it's a rolling window. And for each month, retraining goes on, validation goes on, and trading goes on. So in a way that, you know, the agent with the best performance score coming out of the validation period would be able to do the trading in the next period. So this is how they compete. And the graph that you see is actually evaluation that I did, and I did a comparison with the baseline. So yes, and then I would be sharing with you the results as well. So this is how the architecture looks like. And like all the AI engineers and data scientists, we love to show how, what efforts we made and how we came to the end point. So I'll just give you a little bit of a walkthrough of what exactly I did to, you know, to prepare that system. So I started off with the research, like all of us do. I wanted to see whatever work has been done in this domain and how I can build on top of this. So yes, this is how I came to the problem question or the statement. And then, so once that was done, I wanted to select the time period of where the trading and the training is going on. So for that time period, I wanted to expose the model or to see the performance of the models or train the models through a variety of market environment or the market situations, like to cover the inflation and expansion. So I looked into the GDP historical trend or whatever, the trend analysis of that, and then the historical stock prices, looked into that, and then selected the periods. So once I had the period selected, I wanted to then select the portfolio that the agents would be exposed to. So like I told you initially in my first slide of the topic, this portfolio or the stocks that I selected were basically from S&P 500, the top five volatile and top five stable stocks. And I wanted to explore how the three agents are behaving for this kind of arrangement, right? So once I had the parameters selected, portfolio selected, the time period selected, next step was to collect the data, prepare the data to be fed into the model and, you know, to prepare the environment. Yeah. So for this, the main part was to do the sentiment classification, get the Kaggle news, do the sentiment classification, and then prepare the whole data frame to be fed into the environment. Yes. So when the model was prepared, the data was prepared, next was to construct the model. So initially I told you guys that I used this OpenAI Gem and then Stable Baseline, but then there's another tool, FinRL, and it exposes these packages, plus it provides a very good ensemble strategy methodology as well. So using this tool, I was able to pretty quickly sort of develop all this ensemble strategy. So once once everything was installed and initialized, the tools, I then went into setting up the environment. And like I showed you guys, the blue strip in the architecture, the state space or the environment where the agents operate in has like the balance and purse stock, price, share count, technical indicator values, and sentiment analysis, sentiment scores. And then there is action space, like how the agents are operating. What is the space? So that action space is basically coming from minus K to plus K, where minus K is the maximum shares that an agent, the agents can actually, you know, buy or sell, right? So minus would be selling and buying would, and plus would be buying. Yeah. So once the environment was set up, I initialized the three models with their hyperparameters. So I selected A2C, PPO, and DDPG. And these are all three of them are actor-critic, based on actor-critic algorithm. So yes, once these were initialized, I developed the ensemble strategy, initialized it. And like I told you before, and if you look at this, the first one in the first period, you see the A2C scoring is the best, is like the A2C sharp ratio is the best. So it is selected to do the trading for the next period. And what sharp ratio is, it's a performance metric that is used in stock trading. So it is a discounted version of, you know, annual return in, of the overall return indicator. So that's what I use to, you know, as a threshold or as a performance indicator to do the, to for the agents to compete against each other's. Yeah, so this is how the whole environment of ensemble strategy looks like. And now the results. So I created three situations. One is where I combined most volatile and most stable stocks together and then had the agents do the training and trading. So if you see here, compared to the baseline, there is a 35% improvement in cumulative return. The most interesting part that I saw was the blue line is actually the agents that are the system that's performing. So you see, you don't, in the 500 days, you don't see that bad of a dip. So the performance of the agents were like, they didn't take us to losses, right? And if you see the top five volatile stocks, not as good, just 9% improvement compared to, actually it's a decrease compared to the baseline. But then the least, there was an improvement of 53%. So yes, so this is pretty much it about the autonomous stock portfolio management system using deep reinforcement learning. But there can be, like you guys can see, there are multiple combination of environment, technical parameters that you can select. And so what I did initially, there was no sentiment scores added, but when I added the sentiment score, I saw big value coming out of it. So there are multiple things that we can try and, you know, get a very much optimized and, you know, giving high valued performance system. So this is pretty much it about the reinforcement learning part. Sorry. However, with generative AI, since there has been a boom in the last 2 years, so I wanted to explore how the decision, investment decision making, how we can leverage generative AI in this vertical exactly. So I developed a generative AI based stock recommendation system. And so let me just give you a little bit of a snapshot and then we'll go into the demo as well. So it is actually a RAG and a React based system. And I have developed it using LangChain. So the outcome of it is once a user inputs any of the stock name as a prompt, it would go and it would get all the details about that stock and then give you an answer in the form of either buy, hold, or sell with justification. And so the UI that I developed was using Streamlit because at least for me, I am not a front-end developer expert, so and that can even take a lot of time. So Streamlit does a magic, amazing job, and then you can have a good-looking UI prepared just using Python. So let me just go walk you through the workflow. The user inputs a prompt, I type in Apple. The system would go and get the ticker name. And then it would go get the historical data for the stock. Like I set it up to the last 10 years, it would go and bring all the data for that Apple, okay? And then it would go and get financial statements for Apple. After that, it would go and scrape the web to get stock news for Apple, for that particular stock. And once it has all that information, it would do a critical thinking. And based on just that information, it would give you a result of either buy, hold, and sell with justification. So doing this, we are mitigating the hallucinations, right? So yes, that's the output that comes out. And now let me just take you through the demo. So you put in the API key. And by the way, this is available online as well. You put in the stock name. It would go and get the ticker name for this. So it got the ticker name for this. Next thing, it would go and get the stock prices for it. Again, it would go get the financial statements for Tesla. And then once it has all of that information, then it would let you know if the agent, if the user should buy, hold, or sell with justification. So yes, this is pretty much it. I feel that both predictive AI and generative AI, both of them, they have their own power. They have both their advantages. So, you know, if we combine both of them together, we can have an even enhanced autonomous stock recommendation system. And I am planning to work on this as my future goal as well. So yeah, just that. And that being said, Databricks provides multiple capabilities to support that kind of work. It exposes those libraries and provide that sort of computing resources, managed computing resources to take this type of systems to enterprise scale. So yeah, this is pretty much it.